seventh Sunday after Trinity. But our hymns reflect that during this week we have kept the feast of St. Mary of Magdala and of St. James. And so this Mass reflects all of these intentions, and most particularly the intention of our chaplaincy congregations. We sing, Ye Watchers and Ye Holy Ones. That we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life. To the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, who take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name. Increase in us true religion. Nourish us with all goodness. And of your great mercy, keep us in the same. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Then Laban said to Jacob, because you are my kinsman, should you therefore serve me for nothing? Tell me, what shall your wages be? Now Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah's eyes were lovely, and Rachel was graceful and beautiful. Jacob loved Rachel. So he said, I will serve you 7 years for your younger daughter, Rachel. Laban said, it is better that I give her to you than that I should give her to any other man. Stay with me. So Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed to him but a few days because of the love he had for her. Then Jacob said to Laban, give me your wife, that I may go in to her, for my time is completed. So Laban gathered together all the people of the place and made a feast. But in the evening he took his daughter Leah and brought her to Jacob, and he went in to her. Laban gave his maid Zilpah to his daughter Leah to be her maid. When morning came, it was Leah. And Jacob said to Laban, which is this you have done to me? What is this that you have done to me? Did I not serve with you for Rachel? Why then have you deceived me? Laban said, this is not done in our country, giving the younger before the firstborn. Complete the week of this one, and we will give you the others also in return for serving me for another 7 years. Jacob did so and completed her week. Then Laban gave him his daughter Rachel as a wife. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response to Psalm 128, how abundant is your goodness, O Lord. Happy is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. You shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands. You shall be happy, and it shall go well with you. How abundant is your goodness, O Lord. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children will be like olive shoots around your table. Thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. How abundant is your goodness, O Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. May you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. How abundant is your goodness, O Lord. A reading from St. Paul's epistle to the Romans. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those who he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son in order that he might be the firstborn within a large family. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own Son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor any power shall be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus put before the crowd another parable. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to someone who sowed good seed in his field. But while everybody was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared as well. And the slaves of the householder came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did these weeds come from? He answered, an enemy hath done this. The slave said to him, then do you want us to go and gather them? But he replied, no, for in gathering the weeds you would uproot the wheat along with them. Let both of them grow together until the harvest, and at harvest time I will tell the reapers, collect the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. Then Jesus left the crowds and went into the house, and his disciples approached him, saying, explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field. He answered, the one who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed are the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one. And the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all causes of sin and evildoers, and they will throw them into the furnace of fire, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Let everyone who has ears to hear listen. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In a Franciscan publication, the author speaks of St. Mary Magdalene, and his take on her is very interesting. Except for the mother of Jesus, he writes, few women are more honoured in the Bible than Mary Magdalene. Yet she could well be the patron of the slandered, since there has been a persistent legend in the church that she is the unnamed sinful woman who anointed the feet of Jesus in St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 7. Most scriptural scholars today point out that there is no exegetical basis for confusing the two women. Mary Magdalene, that is of Magdala, was one of whom Christ cast out seven demons in Luke chapter 8. An indication at the worst of extreme demonic possession or possibly severe mental illness. Writing in the New Catholic Commentary, Wilfred Harrington OP says that seven demons do not mean that she has lived an immoral life, a conclusion reached only by mistaken identification with the anonymous woman in Luke chapter 7. In the Jerome Bible Commentary, which is my preferred scholarly work, and during my priestly time, there have been two fine editions. Despite the later Western romantic tradition about her, Edward Malley, S.J., agrees that she is not the same woman as that of Luke chapter 7. She was one of the many who were assisting Jesus and the 12 out of the means they had. She was one who stood by the cross of Jesus with his mother Mary. And of all the official witnesses who might have been chosen for the first awareness of the resurrection, she was the one to whom that privilege was given. She is then known as the apostle to the apostles. Mary of Magdala has been a victim of mistaken identity for almost 20 centuries. Yet she would no doubt insist it makes no difference. We are all sinners in need of the saving power of God, whether our sins are lurid or not. More importantly, we are all unofficial witnesses of the resurrection. This 20 centuries of doubt was expressed in a parish where I worked in central London called St. Mary Magdalene Munster Square. It had the first coffee shop and bar opened by the Bishop of London for the many who lived in the social housing in the area. Prior to the building of the flats, it had in fact been the place to go to find a prostitute. Even into the 19th century and further on, Mary of Magdala was confused with a woman of little virtue. But if you had seen the film, The Passion of Christ, she is presented very powerfully, a strong woman with a love for Jesus. So strong that if it could have happened, she would have gladly taken his place during the Passion. There is then something special about this unique woman. And the Gospel reminds us that from the beginning of our Lord's life and ministry, women played a most significant role. And today, they have so much to contribute to the church and to the people of God. They are a force for good that shouldn't be neglected or undervalued. This is not the same argument that some make for the ordination of women or not. It's just that the church could not exist without its faithful women. Mary Magdalene offers us all, whether female or male, an exemplary witness to the loving purposes of God through the man he loved, Jesus Christ, our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Father, we praise your holy name for all the servants who have served you here on earth and who are now with you in the heavenly realms, particularly those who were close to our Lord Jesus Christ himself during his earthly ministry. We thank you for today's saints who work tirelessly and self-sacrificially to witness to the loving purposes that are yours for the world. For your servants in holy orders, recently ordained to serve you in the churches up and down our lands, and especially here in Malta. We pray in our diocese for those who have been and are to be ordained by both Bishop Robert and Bishop David. We pray for those who lead us at times of crisis. And we pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, and for Pope Francesco, for his global ministry. Here in Malta, we pray for Charles, the Archbishop and Metropolitan, for his Vicar General Bishop Joseph, and in Gozo, where our local community works tirelessly ecumenically. We pray for Bishop Mario as he prepares to go to work in the Vatican City as secretary to the Synod of Bishops in the Vatican. And we pray for his successor, Bishop Anton, that his will be a fruitful and loving episcopate. And we continue to pray for our chaplaincy here and in Gozo, as we work together both for the witness of the Gospel and to give service to you, whom we love with all our hearts. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
Father, we pray for the nations of the world. We continue to pray for Malta, for its place in the Mediterranean, welcoming so many people for refreshment and peace. And at this time, post-coronavirus, we pray for all tourists, visitors, holidaymakers,
pray for our President George, for his wife, and those who advise him in all his responsibilities. We pray for Elizabeth, our Queen, and at this time we continue to pray for her husband, Prince Philip, the patron of this cathedral church. We pray for all national leaders as they deliberate for the good of the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, we pray for our families and our friends, our loved ones, our spouses and our partners, our children, our grandchildren, our nieces, our nephews. We pray for grandparents, particularly at this time. And we pray for schools, colleges, and universities as they prepare over the summer to welcome again students. And particularly for church schools and places of higher education that adhere to Christian principles of love and service above self. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, we pray for the sick, especially those who have died recently. We pray also for those who we know who have asked for our prayers. And we continue to pray for men and women persecuted for their Christian witness. We give thanks for the rebuilding of the cathedral in Aleppo, for the work of the aid to the church in need, for those institutions and groups who seek to bring reconciliation between Christians and people of other faiths. And at this time of confrontation, we pray for all who visit the great temple of Hagia Sophia in Istanbul, that its Christian past will be valued, continued, and strengthened. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, we pray for the faithful departed. And particularly, we continue to pray for Prebendary Scott. Bill Scott, a great friend to many and a priest of wisdom and understanding. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. And may light perpetual shine upon him. May he rest in peace.
Amen.
Uniting our prayers with those of the ever Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Our Lady, Saint Mary Magdalene, Saint James the Great, and our patrons, we commend ourselves and the whole of creation to your unfailing love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We sing the hymn, Let Saints on Earth in Concert Sing.
Thank you.
which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands, to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his church. Father, in your saints, Mary of Magdala and St. James the Great, you give us guiding principles to follow our Lord Jesus Christ wherever he wishes. May that self-same Christ be with us now through your Holy Spirit as we pray that these gifts of bread and wine may become for us his most precious body and blood. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. We rejoice in the glorious splendor of your majesty, for you have given us a share with Mary of Magdala and St. James in the inheritance of the saints in light. In the darkness of this passing age, they proclaim the glory of your kingdom. Chosen as lights in the world, they surround our steps as we journey on towards that great city of eternal light, where they sing the everlasting song of triumph, in communion with angels and archangels, and all who have served you on earth and worship you now in heaven, we raise our voices to proclaim your glory, forever praising you, and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice, we bring before you these holy gifts, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share these holy gifts, so that we in the company of Our Lady, St. Mary of Magdalene, St. James, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be always with you and with your spirit. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son is the true vine and the source of life, ever giving himself that the Word may live, may we so receive within ourselves the power of his death and passion, that in his saving cup we may share his glory and be made perfect in his love. For he is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love. Defend you upon every side, and guide you into the ways of truth and of peace, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. We sing the hymn, God Who Sitteth Sure Foundation.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the Holy Ghost.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we be worthy of the promises of trust.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.